Splines are a great tool that can enhance how you make your games. You can use them to improve game visuals or even assist with gameplay features such as making NPC movement routes and much more. Unity now has an official spline tool which gives you the power of splines in a very simple and easy to use package. Here's how to work with Spline and how you can easily use its basic components to spawn and animate objects. To install the package, open the package manager window, make sure you're filtering for a Unity registry, search for Spline and install the package. To start creating a spline, right-click the hierarchy and go to the spline option. Or, you can use the game object menu in the top to do the same. You can start a spline with a few shapes or use the draw spline tool to create it. By using the draw tool, you can click on the view to create the spline points, called knots, and draw the spline shape. You can also click and drag while creating the knots to have more control over the curvature. When you're done, disable the draw icon or simply press enter to finish the spline creation. This will create an object with the spline container component, which holds the spline's information. To be able to see and add to your spline, make sure the spline tool icon is enabled in the tools overlay. This will display the handles and allow you to manipulate the spline. There are two main ways to manipulate the spline. Clicking and dragging the blue indicator will move the knot in the XZ axis. And while holding the mouse button, you can also hold the Alt key to move it in the Y direction instead. Alternatively, you can click the knot to select it and enable the default transform handles. Here, you can move it just like any other Unity object. Selecting the knot this way will display the element inspector. You can select how spline curves are drawn here. Linear for direct lines, auto for very rounded lines, and bezier for a more refined control, which will show tangent lines that you can use to control curves. Continue curves will allow you to set different distances for each tangent points. Choose mirror if you want smooth curves. And broken for sharp turns and complete control. By selecting the position handle to center, you can use the rotate and scale tools to move multiple knots together. The spline package comes with three different components ready for use. Spline Instant Shape lets you spawn objects along the spline with a lot of customization options. Add the component to the spline and click on the plus button to add a slot, and drag the object prefab you want to spawn. You can control how far apart objects are by changing the distance. And selecting the checkbox below will give you the spawn object and offset. Let's fix the rotation of this object now by rotating 90 degrees in the Y axis. The scale offset means how much scale is added to the object, so a scale offset of 1 will double the object size. The spawned object rotation will be aligned to the knot's rotation. With the spline tool enabled, you can select the knot and use the rotate transform to rotate its direction. You can also randomize any offset values by selecting random and setting the min and max values. By using the random offset, you can quickly place decoration objects in your scene. If you want to rotate the spline in its local direction, you can do so by selecting elements in the rotation handle. This will allow you to rotate the knot in its local directions, instead of the global ones. To showcase how you can solve some common problems, let's create a tree line for our scene. Instead of setting the distance between objects, you can also select instance count and set a fixed amount of spawns. As you can see, the tree will rotate to follow the spline orientation, which is not what we want in this case. To solve this, enable rotation offset and turn on override space to word space to ignore the spline alignment. We can also add multiple prefabs to our spawns, and set a chance of them being instantiated. As a final touch, let's give some offset position to the tree line. The second component is the animate component, which can be used to move an object along the spline. On the object you want to move, add the spline animate component and assign the spline you want to follow to the slot. Use the play button or scroll to preview the animation. You can control the speed by changing the duration, or change it to speed instead and set the velocity. Changing the easing will control how your animation behaves. You can also change the loop mode to move the object back and forth. You can use Spline Animate's great rules to move objects like cameras and NPCs in your game. You can offset the animation by creating an empty parent and animating that instead. This will allow you to move the child object and offset the position. The extrude component will extrude our mesh around the spline. Adding the component will automatically create a mesh render to the object, and it will create a mesh file in your project that is recreated every time you change the components option or the spline. You can enable the draw tool icon to create another spline inside the same object. The new spline will be created inside the container components, which can be seen in the inspector. You can display only the points of a single spline by selecting the spline inside the spline container. You can also join two splines by selecting two knots at the endpoints of the spline, or split them by selecting a knot and clicking the split option. Using the close option will set if your spline loops or not. If you want to make intersecting roads, you can link two knots and have them move together. Select both points and click the link button. Now, you can move both roads together. You can also unlink them to undo this behavior. To create a new point in the middle of the spline, you can use the draw tool and click the spline line. This will create a linked point with the new created spline. Then, hit Ask and cancel the creation of the spline, keeping only the new knot on the curve. And that's it! The spline tool is a simple but effective tool that gives you the basic functionality to manipulate splines, and comes with some components that can get you started using splines to help make your games. You can also expand upon it to make very complex and useful things. I hope you like this, and until next time!